Jillian Lazary, and this is my case study. Cody is the student that I'll work with during the semester. He is in a general education setting. He does not receive any special education services. He is 11 years old and is an only child. His father is not in the picture, but he does live with his mom in an apartment. She works long nights as a housekeeper. The mission statement at Roberts Elementary is to be caring community school staffed with sincere, dedicated professionals who provide every child with every chance for success every day. Cody enjoys riding his bike when he gets home from school. He also enjoys playing video games on his Wii. He likes to build things with his Legos, and his favorite food is steak. Also, Cody would love to have a dog of his own. His uncle does own two dogs that he gets to play with on many occasions, but he would really want one of his own. Cody has such a bright personality and can be quite animated when he describes his likes and dislikes. Even though he can be shy, he enjoys talking to his fellow classmates. His greatest strength is math. His teacher has told me that he has improved since fourth grade in his math and is really doing well. His weaknesses include reading and processing information from his brain to paper. He struggled in all his writing assignments that were assigned during when I had a writing lesson plan. The teacher had to constantly check on him to make sure he was working like he should be. I had to walk around and make sure that he was staying on task and doing what he should have been. I interviewed my teacher of several things. She has told me that the student has improved in math, but he does have a problem with mumbling when speaking. He needs to speak clearer and with more volume. Cody is very distracted. He will space out and not complete his work. He is behind in reading and science. Cody is not a behavioral problem, but he has several breakdowns when he cries and tells the teacher that he does not want to do the assignment. He only does this because he's being lazy and does not want to complete his work. He only does this during reading and history and science. Academically, Cody has excelled in math for the past 2 years. The teacher has been with Cody since fourth grade and has watched his knowledge of math expand. He struggles in reading history and science, so he has been placed in a group of students that learn at a slower pace. I observed Cody in several different settings. For about 30 minutes in each setting, which were the classroom, gym, and cafeteria. In the classroom, I observed Cody during a math lesson. I noticed that during the math lesson, he was not on task, and he would get distracted. But when you sat down with him and worked one-on-one, he got back on task and completed his work. He would answer questions that the teacher asked. During PE time, Cody had no issues with socializing and participating in the games played in PE. He did everything that was asked of him to do. During cafeteria, I did notice that Cody sat at the end and was not very social with his classmates. He did try, but he would get upset and end up breaking down crying because nobody else was talking to him. His social strengths and weaknesses. This is the sociogram that I did of Cody, where I asked him who were his three best friends, who were three people he would like to get to know, who he sits with at lunch. He pretty much chose the same three students that he talks to and sits by at lunch. He only talks and hangs out with the few students from his class, even though he's been with the same classmates for the past 2 years now. I really wanted Cody to work on talking with other people that he doesn't really talk with, and becoming more social. He does not like being out of his comfort zone, but I really was trying to push him to make new friends. He's a bright student who could use some new connections, who can make new connections with his peers. The lesson plan. I taught a lesson plan on how to multiply and divide fractions in the sixth grade class. I provided several examples on the board of how to divide and multiply fractions. I even gave them the step process on how to solve these equations. At the end of my lesson, the students were to work on problems from the workbook. Cody seemed to struggle at first, but I ended up giving him a copy of the step process. From there, he was able to complete his work and even put away the step process to do other problems on his own. Effective interventions. I would say the most effective interventions that I had with Cody was working one-on-one. He seemed to be much more social when it was just the two of us, and he expressed what his problems were in his work and what he struggled in. He was the type of student that needed visual representations, and I would give him positive feedback on the assignments that I had him complete. When I first met Cody, he seemed a bit lost, and he was very shy. He was intimidated by the sixth grade setting altogether. He was the shortest in his class, where all his fellow male classmates were towering over him, even some females. He had very few friends, and even they sometimes would not really pay him attention. His problem was that he would be quiet and not really interact with them or talk about interests that or share his interests with anybody. I worked on with him one-on-one most of the time I spent in the class. My biggest challenge was getting him motivated to complete his work. He always felt intimidated by the work he was to complete, so he would most of the time stare off into space and not do it. Everyone else would be completing their assignments and he hasn't even started. I also wanted to work with him on his social skills. By the time it was the end of my time with him, I did notice he had found his footing and even made several new friends.